Jessica, let's start with you. After hearing the justices this week, is there any doubt that we'll see a rolling back of abortion rights? And what will that mean for women in this country and their very personal decisions on whether to continue with a pregnancy or to terminate that pregnancy?
Yeah, great question. I think after listening to oral arguments, there's no doubt that we're going to see a rollback of Roe v. Wade. And really the only question is, are we going to see that sentence in the Supreme Court case that says we are now overturning Roe and Casey? Or will they try and find that middle ground that it looked like Chief Justice John Roberts wanted to find, where he says something like, we're upholding the central promise of Roe, but that promise is just much narrower than you thought it was. It allows for Mississippi's 15-week ban. What does it mean for women in this country, you asked? It means that we're basically living in two Americas. We're living in an America where women have access to an abortion in states like California. And then other women are living in states, probably about 20 states throughout the country, where they'll either have essentially or no access to abortion.
Let me pick up on that thread that you mentioned, Chief Justice Roberts thinking out loud, really, about changing the existing protection for a woman to terminate a pregnancy from viability, i.e. 23, 24 weeks, to Mississippi's much more restrictive 15 weeks. Will his fellow conservatives on the court be satisfied with that?
It didn't sound like it. Now, we always have to be careful about reading too much into what we hear in oral arguments, but you heard very clearly the Chief Justice kind of doing what he does, right? Casting about for something narrower, where you don't have that earthquake of we're overturning Roe. They're just essentially hobbling it. But if you listen to the questions, it would be Justice Kavanaugh or Justice Barrett who's most likely to join him. I didn't hear, based on the questioning, either one of them going in that direction. I counted five votes for, yes, let's overturn Roe. Let's say that has no constitutional grounding. Let's leave it to the states. But again, we do have to be circumspect about taking too much from oral arguments.
Katie, let me turn to you. About 135 million people would be impacted by a reversal of Roe v. Wade. California would be largely spared from those restrictions because strong abortion rights laws here. But will this mean we'll see an influx of people coming to California for abortions? And is the state prepared for that?
Well, that is something that abortion advocates and providers and lawmakers here in California are expecting and are trying to prepare for. One study found that should Roe be overturned, California could see a nearly 3,000% increase in the number of women from out of state coming here to get an abortion. In September, Governor Gavin Newsom convened the Future of Abortion Council in the state, which brings together providers and advocates to look at some of the challenges that California currently has when it comes to accessing an abortion, both for out-of-state women and for women in California themselves. So that council is going to be assessing some of the challenges and later this month is expected to come out with a list of recommendations.
Well, you've already done some reporting on that for KQED on what it's like for women in more rural areas of our state and for women who are lower income when it comes to abortion. What did you learn?
Well, a lot of the issues are the same in terms of the fact that it costs money. If you have an abortion medically before 10 weeks, it could cost about $300. If you have to wait longer, it could cost about $1,000. And these might be people who are in minimum wage jobs. They don't have that money. They might not have the car they need to drive to the clinic. If you're in a rural area, that could be hundreds of miles. Rural clinics also don't have regular providers. They come in from places like LA and the Bay Area to provide this service on certain days of the week. So you have less of a window to kind of get it in there, because if you wait too long, you might not be able to get treatment at that clinic. California also allows more a wider range of health providers to actually provide abortions. However, not all of them have access to training, which kind of hampers that law. So that's something the state needs to look at as well.
Jessica, just looking ahead, we have a few seconds left, but what comes next? If Roe v. Wade is overturned, what can we expect legally in the years to come?
So this is the big question, and I increasingly think it doesn't end with Roe. I increasingly think we need to look at the other decisions that are based on privacy rights, substantive due process. We have to think really carefully about what happens with respect to rights for same-sex couples, and even back to the case law that says that you cannot prohibit the use of contraception when it comes to consenting adults. All of that case law potentially is on shaky grounds. I really just can't imagine this absolutely ends with Roe.